Hello everybody, welcome to episode 12 on promoting your print on demand store on VIPR digital channel. My name is Cătălin and I'm a designer for fun. In today's video, we're gonna jump into our website and we're gonna finally create our first blog and we're gonna add some affiliate links there as well. So without wasting time, let's start working. Okay, welcome back to my computer. If you remember yesterday, we have discussed a little bit on what are the main differences between pages and posts and which one will be the best approach for our website. So as a conclusion, we decided to go with pages for our portfolio website to represent our blog. So let's create a blog. So first things first, let's edit. Now here we need to find a way on how to name our blog, because this is quite important, especially when it comes to SEO. So I already wrote the entire blog beforehand and now let's see how to name this. So I can take this part, let's paste it here and let's play around. I can take this one and I can place it in front of how to calculate Redbubble artist margin. Should be fine. Now let's kind of adjust it a little bit. Perfect. And then this will be the title of our blog. So I hit enter, publish, publish. As you can see, this will be our URL. So here, this is how the people will see it on Google. Again, if you want to see how this page will be displayed on Google, don't forget to install Yoast SEO plugin. It is free, by the way. So here, this is how it will be: vipartprints.com, how to calculate your Redbubble artist margin. This part, I will do it later on. The meta description, I may need to change it for this specific page in order to help it rank up for SEO, writing a short summary of the blog into here. Now, let's go and edit with Elementor. Well, you don't really have to edit with Elementor, you can edit with WordPress, but Elementor, it's more easier and flexible. Finally, we are here. So let's start. Now for blogging, I don't really want to add a specific banner. So because of that, I will just jump into it to make things easier and better organized. So I will add a new section and here we're gonna add a heading. Now let's go to our page and let's copy all of this and we're gonna paste it here. Okay, we can make some small adjustments. Okay, let's kind of separate them a little bit. And let's see one more here. Okay, it looks pretty cool, but I don't like this cutout. So I can click here to style, to edit the section. And then from boxes, I can choose full width and it will look pretty cool. But it's not center, so I can go back to the heading and I can click here on the pen and here we're gonna choose center. Perfect, so this will be center to our page. Now let's see what we should write in the blog. So for today's blog, I decided to have a study case on how to calculate your earnings. So what I will do, I started with a hookup, basically a sentence or a paragraph that address the viewers issue and then a quick follow-up of what they can find on the post and then a more detailed explanation of each of these follow-ups plus study cases, and in the end we're gonna finish it with a conclusion and a call of action. So this is what we're gonna try to do today. So let's take the hookup. Okay, let's take this one and here we're gonna create a new section, but this time I want double columns. So let's introduce. Here, we're gonna go to text editor, click and drag it inside, and let's paste the new thing. So wow, this is unbelievable. And let's add an enter here, and an enter here to make a nice separation. We can go to style, and here under typography, let's change to 22. It looks pretty nice. But yet, let's make it more eye-catching. So on this side, I can go to Elementor and I will drag an image and place it inside. Now let's choose something. I will choose this one. I like it. Why? Because look here. What is this? What? This is unbelievable. How is this possible to get so little? This is not my margin. It's a ripoff. Okay. So basically I can separate this one again. Now it's all about aesthetics. But as you can see, those two, they don't match so well. So this one, we need to pad it down a little bit. We need to move it in such a way to match. So we can click on this edit button. We can go to advanced. We click on this to unlink them. And here I can choose for the top 50. And let's see, it goes down. Maybe I can go more. Let's choose 80. 80 seems to do a pretty good job. Again, I can lower it even more if I desire, or I can even increase the size of it. But let's have a quick look on how it will look on the mobile devices. Okay, so this is how it will look there. It's okay. Here on the mock-up devices, we can go back and we can rearrange everything. As you can see, the alignment button is right here and the typography is here. So as you can see, for the size on the mobile. So if I want here, we can play around with the size. If the size is too big, from here we can change it in order to fit better, because right now, as you can see, it's not so good. So we can go down probably to like 18, 17 or 15. Let's see. 15 will be pretty nice. Let's see, 17. Yeah, 17 will do a good job. So this is really good to know all this stuff. So we can go on the tablets. On the tablet seems to be okay. We don't need to adjust this at all. Well, this part I highly suggest you to do, especially when you finish your blog. Make sure that your blog will look very good on all of your devices. Now let's go further. Let's go back to our blog, and here we inserted the image, and let's take this one. Sound familiar? As an artist, it is important to get familiar with the way the pricing and payments work on Redbubble. Perfect. Now let's take this one. Let's go here and let's add a new section. This time I just want to add a text editor, and we're gonna paste in the new information. Now, this one, I do not want to go to style and center it. No, this one, I want it to be placed on the left side of the screen. In this way, the page will be more organized. And what I can do on the other hand, I can go to typography and let's increase the size to 22. Okay, so now those will match throughout the entire blog. Again, let's go here and let's see. Here we can introduce now a video. So I will click on this plus button, introduce a new section, go here, I will choose video, and I will drag and drop. Why? Because on YouTube, we already created a video based on this. So let's head over very fast to YouTube, and I will paste the link here. Okay, so I will just go here, Control V, remove, and paste in the new link. Here, I want to make sure lazy load is on. The others, I will add them as they are. Why? Because in this way, if I scroll on the top, there will be a subscription button. And this is what I want. So now they can watch the video directly on the website. Again, we can go to here and have a quick look. As you can see, all is really nice. Okay, so now the video is up and running. Perfect. Now let's go back here and I will just copy paste the entire thing. So basically, I will just go here, take this part, go back, insert a new section. Now you may ask, why do I need to insert new sections? Well, I will show you later on why I prefer to do it this way. Because later on, as you can see, those bullet points, they will actually be anchor points. So it's something that we're gonna use it in order to navigate the page. So here I can go again to style, typography, 22. Perfect. Now let's add something new, but before that, let's go here and let's add another one. Okay, same as before. As you can see, the entire process is really fast. Okay, style, typography, 22. Now let's add something else. Let's go back to see. Here we're gonna have what is the base price. So this one will be a header. So I will take it. I will introduce a new section and we're gonna go here. We're gonna take the heading. We're gonna take the heading, place it, and let's paste in this. And this one, I'll let it an H2 because it's quite important. The top one, this one should be an H1. Let's see, H2, let's change to H1. Perfect. In this way, Redbubble will know what to read on our website. But for now, I will let it as it is. We're gonna play a little bit with aesthetics later on. So here, what is our base price? What the reason why I have created this, because I want to click on this button, and here we're gonna go to the advanced, and here we have a CC ID, and let's call this base price, and we're gonna copy it, okay? Now, the reason why we've done this, because here under the base price, let's click here, we go to content and we highlight the base price, and we're gonna click on this link button. Now, in the beginning, we're gonna type a hashtag, and then we're gonna paste in base price. We're gonna click apply. Now, if I update, let's see what actually happened. And let's preview. So, as you can see, wow, this is unbelievable. How it is possible to get so little? Perfect. And then watch the video. And if I click on the base price, it should theoretically take me here. But we don't see so many things because we do have to put more information. This is already on the bottom. So what is the base price? Actually here, let me duplicate this one. Okay, I will delete this. And here I want to insert a logo, an image. Why? Because that will be an image that will represent the base price throughout our planning. So I'll go here, I'll choose base price, insert media. Perfect. This is too big, so I can choose thumbnail. Nice. Now let's add a new section and let's go back here and let's see what we have. Well, we can copy this one. New section, insert text, paste it, go to style, typography 22. Perfect. Let's go back here. But where can we find the best price? This is actually quite a good question. So let's add another section. This time I want to add a heading. Okay. And let's paste in the new one here. And let's make this an H3. Okay. Because this is actually quite an important question. And if I go back here, I can take this one. And I can paste this one here, and let's stylize it to 22. Well, too much. And I have some problems. Perfect. So we have this part, and let's bring in. So the first way, I will take this one. Again, bring a new section. Text editor and paste in here. Same as before, change it to 22. Okay, so we have finished building our blog and it's quite a lot of information covered, and that is awesome. But yet we do want to monetize this one way or another. As a good practice, is not recommended to add Google AdSense right now to your blog. This one we're going to do it later on, once this blog page will have quite a significant amount of traffic. But right now, we do not want to do that. But yet we still want to increase the chances of making some money out of it. So the best approach will be with affiliate links. The best affiliate program that you can join to is Amazon affiliate program. I already joined in there. So let's head over there and let's see how it looks like. Well, all you have to do is to sign up, and it's very easy. Just follow the steps that they require you to do so. But there are two conditions. One, either you have a website or you have a YouTube channel. Otherwise, you are not able to join into Amazon Associate Program. It will take up between 1 to 3 days to get approved into their platforms. Once you get approved, this is what you're gonna get on your homepage. And now let's see, what can we add on our blog? So as you can see on our site, we are trying to help artists to fix a problem, to understand about the artist margin. But we can take this blog and we can also add other tips there as well. And what do I mean by that? We can give them some book suggestions that they can purchase from Amazon. Let me go here and fix this part very fast. Okay, now let's see. If I go back here, I want to search for some e-commerce books, shall we? And let's write, for example, e-business and e-commerce. Those are the ones that Amazon is pushing forward. So actually this one is really good, digital business and e-commerce management. Okay, I just need to choose get link. Now here I can take this one as it is. As you can see, this will be a live preview or on how this book will look like on our website. So all we have to do is to take this and add a short code. Or if we want, we can go to text only or image only. So if it's an image, we're gonna get this image that we can actually paste it on our website. Or in our case, just take this one. And here, I will just choose short link. And I'll just take this link and add it to my website. Okay, so let's take the name of the book. And we can go back to our website. And here, somewhere around, for example, what is the base price? Before of that, we can add a new header here and we can write, let's bring in a text editor. And here you can write something like, and let's paste in the URL. Sorry, let's paste in the name of the book. We go back to Amazon, we take the short link, we go back to our website. And here we just highlight this digital business management, add the link, paste in the URL, apply, edit, pack, and we're going to choose open in a new tab, update, and update. And voila, this is how we have created our own blog and we have added an affiliate link. Of course, off camera, I will spend much more time on Amazon to find the best books that I should recommend for our customers. This is actually quite important. You don't want just to throw any random books. Do your research, find the best recommendation for your viewers. Okay guys, so that's it for today's video. I will leave an update version of this blog down into the description, so do check it out. And also, if you have any questions about affiliate links, or you want me to make more detailed videos about affiliate marketing, please leave a comment down in the comment section. I would love to hear from you. And stay tuned for tomorrow. Why? Because tomorrow we're going to jump in on YouTube and we're going to create different YouTube templates that we can use to advertise our products on a multitude of social media platforms. So until tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye-bye.